I can't resist this. I had this friend many years ago. Her parents were Chicago political people. She grew up in this world of political, and would get Aunt Sally the job as the such and such because, you know, it's a good job, good pension, and everything. And she said to me, she in her house, this is what her house was like. Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? Negotiation of power for what purpose is it? Is it just, you know, in her family's case, it was a family business, and it was just to keep the make sure that everybody right. in the family had a decent job.
Right.
It doesn't seem that far away in what these other people are doing.
Well, it's machine politics, and Tammany Hall lives. Boss Tweed is alive and well and thriving here in New York. I mean, the historic origins of it are kind of interesting because, of course, when you had wave and wave of immigrants coming from Europe, and then later Asia and other parts of the world in the late 19th, early 20th centuries, you had a lot of people coming over who needed jobs, who needed services. And so the Democratic Party became the party of immigrants. In order to service those immigrants, it set up political machines. And those political machines helped get people elected and sustain them in power. And so there was a corrupting influence which continues to this day. Of course, both parties are thoroughly corrupt. But the heart of both parties, but here in this city, the Democratic Party, is this model of doing politics, which is a model of Tammany Hall, Boss Tweed, party bosses who call the shots. I mean, I've explained to friends and activist colleagues how all of the speakers of the city council were elected. And up until Melissa Mark Viverito, who was really put in the speaker's chair by the mayor for the first time, that was fairly unprecedented, Bill de Blasio, her predecessors were all put in the speaker's chair by the Queen's party boss. And there's a particular political mechanism of how that works, and I could explain it to you. It's a little bit detailed. But essentially, the party bosses have played an outsized role in politics in the city. I live in Queens, and I have to deal with the Queens machine. It is a corrupt machine. They are, however, more skillful in their corruption than the Brooklyn machine, where people literally bring paper bags filled with cash. In Queens, you know, they're a little bit more sophisticated than that, and they're able to use techniques and tactics which are just barely within the realm of the legal, but are still nonetheless